Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Asad International Camp in 2021. Today I am going to discuss here that what is the Pythagorean theorem and what is the relationship between Pythagorean and Pythagoras and what is the proof of Pythagorean theorem. Everything is available in this lecture, which is the course of Math GCU Grand Canyon University. So video is very interesting and must watch this lecture from starting to end. So without wasting any time, let's solve the lecture. So here, first of all, I discuss here that what is the relationship between Pythagorean and Pythagoras. Pythagorean is a derived term of Pythagoras. You can write Pythagoras and Pythagorean are both are similar. And this first step and second step is here, what is the Pythagorean theorem? The Pythagorean theorem is the scale of the hypotenuse of a right triangle, which is here in this right triangle, which is angle of 90 degree. It is here the hypotenuse, the scale of the hypotenuse of a right triangle. That is, you can write here C squared, that is equal to the sum of squares of two sides. You can write here sum of squares of two sides, which are A and B, and A is the perpendicular scale. You can write here A square plus, which is the sum of B. B is the base. So we write here C square is equal to A square B square. This is the Pythagorean theorem, or you can write here Pythagoras theorem. But in this lecture, in third step is very important for you, in which I will prove that how C square is equal to A square B square. So must watch this important point. Don't skip any step. So first of all, I'm going to discuss to prove C square is equal to A square plus B square. In this figure, you have to draw a line from C to this line. You can write here and draw a line from C to this. Now write line from perpendicular line from C to this A to B. Alright, let's suppose that this is CD. So here CD is perpendicular to AB. You can write here, so CD is perpendicular to this sign shows here perpendicular. So CD is perpendicular to AB. Right here, CD is perpendicular to AB. So in this sign, so must remember for proof C square is equal to A square B square, you have to draw a line from this to this. So you have to get here CD is perpendicular to AB. So this this triangle had decomposed in two figures. You can write here first, which is ADC. First is ADC. Triangle is ADC, and this is a BDC. This is a second figure, which is the second right triangle. You can write here, which is the second point is here a BDC. That could be another point. So here the triangle ABC splits into two triangles. First is ADC, and the second is BDC. Now let's suppose that this side A to D, I can write here X. You can write here X, AD side is, you can write here, let's suppose that where AD is equal to X and BD, let's suppose that this is Y. So let's suppose that BD side is equal to Y, and last step, CD side, let's suppose that we have H. You can write here this is H. So CD side is here. CD side is given here H. Now, next step, now I'm going to do the last and most important point in which you can easily prove that C square is equal to A square plus B square. Just focus the point. So here, now move here in triangle ADC. The triangle ADC, you can write here triangle ADC, which is approximately to triangle ADC, which is approximately to ACB. You can write here approximately to ACB. So you can write here, similarly, X divided by B in this figure, ADC in this right here, you can write here X divided by B, because this triangle ADC is approximately to triangle ACB, or you can write here X divided by B will be equal to B divided by C. You can write here B divided by C. X prime is for triangle ADC, and B divided C is triangle from ACB whole completely. So simplifying this question, we get the value here. X is equal to B squared divided by C. This, let's suppose that this is equation number one. Now again, you can write here triangle. Now again, I'm going to take in here BDC. Now triangle, I take here BDC, which is approximately to triangle BCA. So this step, just like before, you can write here in BDC, Y divided by A, Y ratio A is equal to A divided by C, is equal to Y divided by A for triangle BDC. In this triangle BDC, we have the figure here, BDC in here, Y divided by A is equal to A divided by C for triangle BCA. I hope that you have cleared the point. And next step will be here, Y is equal to A, multiply by, we get the value here, A squared divided by C. This is the second step. I hope that you have cleared the concepts about that. If you have any problem, you can do the comments below the video. So here, next step. But Y plus X is equal to C, because this is the complete side of C. So in this case, Y plus X will be equal to C. So here, right here, Y plus X is equal to C. So right here, Y value is given here in second part, and X value is given here first part. You can write here from first and second. You can write here from first and second. We will get the value here, Y A squared divided by C plus X. X is given here, B squared divided by C is equal to C. Now simplifying, you get the value here, C squared is equal to A squared plus B. Very easily, this is the very easiest proof of Pythagoras theorem. So here, similarly, this is the sign is similar. So taking LCM, get here, A squared plus B squared. Next step will be here, C will be as it is. We'll get the value here, A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared. So last the proof here. So hence, we proved that C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. I hope that you have cleared the concepts about that. What is the relationship between Pythagoreans and Pythagoras, which are similar? What is Pythagorean theorem and what is the proof of Pythagorean theorem? I hope that you have cleared the concepts. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, kindly must subscribe to my YouTube channel. I must press bell icon button for gaining notification of my new lecture. Goodbye.